Whistle while you work. We was out in the trenches, bro. I needed this just to be out there, man. No, I ain't even gonna hold you.
Main Street to Philly. Literally. Y'all ready?
This is great. You got it.
This is that. Say goodbye.
Yeah.
To what we had.
Yeah, from no streets. One swing knocks you off your feet. No NBA to stand for duck at least.
Duck at least? It's this battle. Bro, I said this about to be over. Because I knew for a fact it was morning.
I feel like I lost somebody today. But, bro, I mean, where you at with it?
You ain't the only one. Remy, my damn near felt it, too. Yo, this got ugly.
If you think he didn't love me, he would have put up with all of this. Yo, Papoose.
Yes, sir.
That's how you talk to your
Yo, Papoose. Somebody literally did that tomorrow, yes sir. Truth be told,
where you at with it?
Easy the Block Captain and Geechee Gotti was crazy.
Keep this on the DL. If you heard that did something to me over a female and he ain't dead, it's probably because I still got the female.
That shook the building.
Yeah.
Dawn said it's tiny because I still got the female.
Yeah.
Crazy. The entire battle, both guys went in there and did the talking we expected both of them to do.
Right.
From rounds one to round two and all the way throughout round three.
Okay.
Bro, I've been done dirty by I really love. I've been cut off my emotions. Plus, I seen my mom play the part of Superman as a woman at her lowest.
That is crazy. My mom plays Superman at a low, at her lowest, no, lowest length.
Hey, listen.
I said this.
Oh, I looked over at
him. I said, dog trying to run away with it. This was one of those.
It looked like B picked a dope little spot. He did, gotta get through a bunch of rocks and whatnot, but I like it. I think I'm about ready. I think.
Let's hope I don't bust my stuff trying to sit on these rocks. But TT, you got repellent? XB. Alright. Think I'm ready. I'm ready, Zeus.
Now if you try to do one, I'ma do two.
Whoa.
If you try to do three, I'ma do four. Maybe even more. I go by the name of PRLO.
Yeah. Round one, how we feeling? You got Easy the Block Captain who chose to go first.
Right.
Mind you, he didn't allow the coin to even flip.
Right.
Somebody call.
Hey, Camden, Philly, what up?
What up? Finally made it, nigga.
It's Easy versus McFuck.
Let's get straight to these payments, nigga. Rim said, what we doing? He like, hey, yo, turn me up. You know how he do.
The block cap in the building. Yep.
We in the trenches, we here. I'ma set this thing off right.
Probably a Philly angle that's nonsense. A gun title angle need to stop it. Right. I'm a drug dealer. I got behind Rock to make a profit.
Crazy. Now that was fire, nigga.
We was at the battle and I had to hide my little.
No, but see, Rock was right there. Yeah. And the way he
landed it.
He landed it, and then the performance, too, to walk over there to rock.
So he wanted to set the tone early. And for the most part, I felt as though he did just that, very conversational in this round with Easy. How you feel?
I feel the same. I think he jumped right out of the gate. He knew the importance of momentum in this battle.
I start scratching around these thick ass niggas because this situation bad. I knew I was allergic to seafood, but not no imitation crab, nigga. You had.
And he was in that disrespectful with it. You know what that's about.
Right.
That crab word.
You gotta be careful with it. That shit come with a warning.
But he in that bag. I ain't mad at him for wanting to be in that.
He had to do that. And he jumped the gun, and I don't know.
I'm gonna say this. I'm okay. It is a gamble.
It was a gamble.
And I'm not sure if I'm okay with him wanting to go first.
Right.
But I knew he was going off. Rip was going to have them shit shaking.
Right.
And he had them shit shaking throughout the rock bar?
Yeah. Come on. We're not going to pretend like Easy didn't come out the gate and bring it. The way he penmanship and put it together. He came out, man. He came out striking. That's a fact.
Now, but he had to, though.
Yeah.
And then that even led to, like, still got the female bar about the whole Pap shit.
Yeah.
About Rim. He still got the female.
Yeah.
I said, it's probably being a long night.
Let's address this right out the gate.
And mind you, we got to let the people know this is our second time watching the actual battle on the playback. Right. We was in the building.
We was on stage. Yeah.
We was literally in the trenches.
We was in the building.
Walking through that motherfucker. It was hot. It was moggy in there.
Listen.
Like you had motherfuckers with ski masks on. You had bitches
them
in Tim's. Bitches in Tim's with skirts on in that bitch. I'm like, yeah, what's going on in there?
That's a fact.
When we first got there, they was boxing in the back of some
shit. Was there. They were, like, yeah.
Yo,
it was
literally
monkey.
In the middle of the trenches, bro.
But he don't give the coach 100, but y'all pant with him, bro. I will damage him. I done seen Coke intimidate the baking soda. First time we witnessed tampering, so you play too.
I like that. One thing he gonna do is paint. Yeah. The imagery to his bars is gonna be there.
Period.
He gonna illustrate all night long. Homie was in there illustrating Easy. I gotta give it up for him. Homie was in there for all the fuckery.
That's a fact.
We'll make your born day your death day. We go two for twos. We do God a favor. We say happy birthdays at funerals. And you spoil you too.
Bro, we do God a favor. I didn't hear that the first night, bro. That's crazy.
This thing had everything. This might be a one-on-one type of battle.
It's definitely a one-on-one type of battle.
Seen
these motherfuckers got brutal. I mean, it was no hoes bar. It was one of them, like, you wrestling fans out there. This was, you know, a hardcore match mixed with the Hell in the Cell, mixed with the Tombstone matches, the tables, ladders, and chairs. Like, this was all of that and some in this battle, man.
Yeah.
All of it.
All the emotions.
I like the fact that, and I noticed, you know, that Easy tapped into a lot of rhyme cadences in this first round.
Yep.
It's very different, and I felt as though he need to add new elements to his art, and I felt as though Gotti would have to do the same, right? So, and then he also had sneaky lines that just snuck up on this crowd, and the crowd was missing a lot of it.
Yep.
But Easy had sneaky lines that just made so much sense, and it was effective to me.
Bro, you are Marcus to me. That Geechee shit, you don't deserve that. You'll get buried alive, then we visit you. We don't even let dirt nap, nigga. I will talk him.
We don't even let dirt nap, and they barely said a word?
What?
It's shit like that. I thought the crowd should have erupted. That shit fire. Again, he started out on fire. He closed the show out very mid, I would say, but for the most part throughout this round, he had this entire building shaking.
Yep.
Easy was on one. But then Gotti had to go. Oh my God, bro.
Yeah.
I thought the stage was set. I thought it was set.
Yeah.
And then Gotti made me believe, oh, this is another, it's another stage to the setting that needed to happen. This guy, Gotti, even goes crazy in the first.
We got Geechee Gotti versus Come on now, Remy. I know you ain't fucked this corny ass nigga.
Out the gate.
Let's out go, Gotti. Gotti out gate was out all gate. Bullshit and was ready for it. And I'm like, all right, what are we doing here with the first round? How you felt after watching Gotti do his thing on the playback to start to begin the show, though, at the top of his round?
We were both on stage, and I looked at it like, can he get the momentum back? Can he steal this? Because that was such a stellar first round.
It was.
And it's hard to beat,
bro.
But you're going to have to either meet it in the middle or get over it.
Mm-hmm. He did have the same energy, the same aggression.
Facts.
And he matched exactly the attitude that he needed to have towards Easy the Block Captain in this first round.
Who been feeding you lies? I don't give a fuck who you is. I kill any and everything. I don't even let rumors live. Nigga, speaking of rumors.
I don't even let rumors live. I kill everything alive. I don't even let rumors live.
Speaking of rumors. Bro.
That's a fact.
I'm like, yeah, nigga, we gonna need that all night right there. That's crazy. Yeah. That is crazy. But you get what I'm trying to say when we talk elements of the art, like Gotti matched him. I thought he matched him, bro. Like, yeah, I thought Gotti, he definitely
Gotti had a
did
lot
that
of clever bar. He did a lot of relatable, you know. Gotti talked that street shit, but he always talked that street shit. It's like I ain't putting extras on it. Mm-hmm. Like the whole I didn't choose the block chose me type shit. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like he just laced it.
No. He's his face.
Look, yeah,
his
I know.
Face.
Look.
Yeah, pay attention, nigga.
I could have never been a black captain because I didn't choose the block.
The block chose me.
Yeah, bro.
Yeah.
Good luck. Come on.
I like how Gotti is in there.
Keep going, nigga.
Original big dog.
the block chose me.
The round placements in this battle was just crazy.
Because the first time I had to shoot a nigga, I needed to learn how to dance too.
Right.
And that's a fact.
Right.
I tried running, man. My Millie rocked him and he had to get his
cabbage patch. Ah! It's shit like that.
Come on.
The build up. Hey. The dance rhyme scheme that led to the cabbage patch shit?
Right, yeah.
I said, oh my God. Yeah. But then that's where he started to go upstairs from that point moving forward.
That's a fact.
And I'm like, oh, this is about to really be one of them. I just like gave him away and the crowd said nothing. But they was sleeping on a line, bro. Both MCs, though.
Under my fingernails and look like French tips. Bitch,
That's crazy.
Nasty. Nasty work. Come on, man. So much coke.
See, Gotti, honestly, Gotti had the crowd in the palm of his hands at this point. He reached the point where the crowd at this point was, they had no choice but to give it up for him.
Right.
I'm talking about every bar. That shit was quick and shit, bro. Yo, Gotti had some shit too, bro. Yeah. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah.
He was speaking to the life of Easy and quite frankly, cats that was a part of his squad. Gotti and that causing problems with Philly.
And that's that real shit right there, man. It's simple, but listen, that's all attacking his character and the people you hold with.
We only seen Cuz on stage for the last two. Where the fuck was he doing the first 48?
Johnny Mac, first 48, like his whole shit. Yeah. That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy. Yo, come on, dog.
Yep.
He was even talking to them. Remember he told dude, you don't even know his mom name or his grandma name. You don't remember that part?
Yeah.
When Gotti pointed to dude.
He told him, he's like.
He said, dog, young niggas just came around. Yeah.
So, and that was all add-ins.
Yeah.
You know, this filler, even the filler was crazy.
And
even,
like, this? What? So, no, I just wanted to point out, like, so when I saw, when these guys was matching each other, like, you know what I mean? Like, Gotti even got into a rhyme cadence.
Talking open casket.
Yeah.
Because his people might want to see E.
Uh-huh.
The morticians had a hard job, but somehow they made it look like it was E.
Yeah. It is easy.
And when it's real. Yeah.
Y'all can tell.
Y'all can see it in his eyes. Yo, time.
See if you can make niggas believe them lies. Nigga, time.
Yeah.
So it was just like, We ain't really seen Gotti do rhyme cadences.
Yeah.
We ain't never really seen Easy do rhyme. They both was just doing other shit in this battle to win the battle, bro.
Right.
I like this first round, bro. Who you going with, bro? It's very close.
This first round is very hard to judge. It's close. Even in the building, even on our second watch.
The second watch is it's even crazier, close. Bro. It is.
It's still very close.
It is.
It's going to almost say you're going to come down to preference. It's hard. It's hard because they almost, even in the...
My thing is they both had two different haymakers throughout this round that shook this building. And for me, like, that's what makes the round kind of debatable. Now, if Easy had three of them things and Gotti only had two, I'd be like, I'm edging like, right. This is hard, bro. They both lit. I'm going Gotti, bro, on the edge. Slight edge, for real.
I damn near need a third watch. I could call a draw.
You going, I mean, doing draws, bro.
I mean, damn.
Gotti was rapping long as a bitch in this battle, bro.
He was in his bag. That nigga had material. That nigga had a lot of material, nigga. He had a lot of material. He had a lot to talk about.
I don't know. I wouldn't be mad if anybody said they got Easy, for real.
Right.
I wouldn't be mad at all, because it was one of those rounds, like, you know, but I don't know. I don't know. You can go either way. You can go either way. Very debatable round.
Very, very.
Round two jumps off. Let's get into that.
What you got for round two, man? God damn.
Let's get into that.
Marcus King there, Troy the second, Miss Foul, go get it. She called me back in a minute. I said, what it say? She said, Easy. I said, what it say?
He up there performing. I like it.
Yeah, yeah. That's a different element.
Yeah, it's definitely a different element to his game. I'm not like that.
I like that. Yeah.
I said, what it say?
But at this point, I'm like, he got to go, bruh. He got to go. Gotti ended his shit strong. Gotti slow cooks the first round, right, to start the show out. And I felt like this is what Easy did in this round. Very slow cook. And it's just like, dog, I need my food and I need it now. I'm hungry. Mm-hmm. I'm hungry, Easy. I'm hungry.
Potatoes on it.
I don't want to hear about you took no plea, bro. Who the fuck you fooling? You think I'm corny? When you separate your kicks from your Cody, that means you want to tell a whole nother story. But this.
You separate your kicks. And I ain't going to lie. Easy is talking, though.
Yeah, he talking, though. He barking.
You got to understand the system. Yeah. You got to understand the system.
He barking.
And the context that he's talking. So he started out, you know, talking about, you know, Gotti doing the bid and whatnot. And I just don't think this angle was just like, it wasn't effective at all to me. It wasn't effective at all. Knowing, you know, that obviously, you know, if I'm spilling the beans and whatnot, L.I. the mayor, you know, him and the boy did a bid together. Knowing how L.I. still with the boy every event, every time they on the road, L.I. with, he there.
Right.
So it was just like this argument just wasn't it, bro. Did he have dope punchlines?
It makes sense, though, because we talk too much. Nigga, I hate it. Bro, it's the Matrix. If you would have ran into my judge, she don't do verbs. She do nouns. She put people in places. And if you chase...
See, don't she do verbs. Places,
she do nouns.
She like put now, people in now, places. Yeah. It's shit like that. But I felt like the crowd should have been... I like that type of shit. I'm not going to lie, bro. Did he have dope metaphors? Absolutely, but... It was just like, I don't know, bro. What you think, bro?
I would like to say this.
He definitely wasn't rocking the room as much as he was in the first.
I'm going to go on record and say this is the first time we've seen Easy make a not-so-veteran. He made a mistake.
Ooh, yeah, I say that too.
And we talk about this all the time.
I say that too. It's IQ.
Where you get an angle and you spend too much time on that angle.
Yeah.
And then not only did he spend too much time on that particular topic, the topic was deadened because you're talking about a Cody and the Cody's on stage.
It ain't there, bro.
It ain't nothing there.
That's crazy, bro.
It's really nothing there. So you wasted probably about two and a half minutes of your long round.
That's tough.
You know, trying to convince us that, you know, Gotti may or may not, what are you trying to say? He's a snitch.
No, he wasn't saying that.
Not a snitch, but what you're trying to get at, like y'all took a deal.
Yeah.
He did. You going down that? Exactly. You working down
that part.
You working down
not
that
necessarily
avenue.
Snitching,
not
but
a snitch, but you yeah. working. Cooperating.
We don't want to put that on.
We can't cooperate in our culture. Yeah, we facts, don't cooperate. Facts. We don't talk.
Yeah. Like I said, metaphorically, he was definitely in his bag. The heckling. Can we talk about the heckling? The heckling in this battle was crazy. They was the fans, bro. I don't know what they was too invested into this battle.
That's not fire, man. You wear glasses, you don't know it's fire. Hey, listen. Fire, you don't know about no drugs. You don't know about no drugs. I ain't gonna watch nothing. I'm nutty, boy. We'll beat the shit out of you.
Yo, Gotti.
Let's go.
Hey,
he's
no,
really
for real.
Addressing nigga the crowd ASAP.
That's a fact.
That's a fact.
Even one of the homies. Remy even made that nigga move like, bro, you too close to the camera. You got to go. Shout out my dog, Woods. Like,
yo,
like,
Woods
you got to go,
really,
man.
Yeah.
With them niggas, bro. Stop talking through my shit. Stop talking through my shit, nigga.
Yeah, that's Woods. Nigga Woods down there wildin'. I ain't gonna lie, Woods matched the energy. It was some motherfucker in the crowd heckling Gotti.
Yeah, it's only right. Like, it's only right.
That's crazy though. You standing right by the camera. We hear everything you talking about.
Yeah.
But yeah, Easy, he spoke on, you know, the L out of Mayor situation. And then he got into the baby moms.
Yes. He attacked at that. Attacked the baby moms.
And then, you know, the dad. And then everybody else would be stealing. Yeah.
Yeah.
Easy was talking, bro. I'm not gonna lie.
If you the league owner, you gotta protect your price. If Coffee Brown is headlining your event, you gotta kick out the bitches that she don't like. Bro, you gotta.
That's right. That's a fact.
Why
I ain't
not?
Gonna lie.
Why not?
I mean, she bringing the dough in on the night.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You gonna lie? You can't fuck up the bread.
Right.
He got more personal, and then he got even more personal in this round.
You corny as shit.
Yeah, man, he in there talking, bro.
You should be splitting money with your fucking son. I got money.
I ain't gonna lie. He's using that boy.
Yeah.
Trying to algorithm for real. I'm not gonna lie to them, one of y'all. Easy was, he wanted to make a statement, and I felt this, though. In this round, he sure as hell did. And he wanted the world to know how much, but, you know, Geechee Gotti is a gossiper.
Yeah.
I can't write with a battle, no female. You still give me this messy bitch.
Ooh.
Let's go.
Gun,
nigga.
I ain't gonna lie. I like it when I edited it. At this point, I'm like, this battle was up right now.
Yeah.
It's up. Was drilling that. In this round, like, man, this thing he gossiping. Like, yeah. We respect that. Like, right. I like the round for the most part. But then again, that element of surprise, like, everybody literally at this point is on their toes. Like, we want to hear what Dog got to say, too.
But you got to talk about it. Yeah.
What's next? Like, we want to hear. Like, they was spilling so much tea in this battle, bro. Everybody in the room went like this. You gotta do it with me, nigga. Like this. And then look, they even like this. Like, what's going on? They was wilding in there, dog. Wild.
Let's go, L.I.
Hey, that's all facts, true story.
That's what I'm saying, dog. Exactly. Round placement mattering battles like this.
Yeah.
When we having a conversation, you gotta have something to answer to, whatever's being told to you. To bring out L out of Mayor was just like, I said, we knew it.
Yeah.
We said he was in the building.
Mm-hmm.
Gotti brought him out. So it's literally killed his entire round because the round was just about the Cody.
Yep.
And he's in the building.
He's in the building.
At this point, it's like, all right, man.
The credibility went out the window. It's like,
yeah, man. It's
not, you wasted a lot of time for that.
Gotti would talk about how less than he is.
If I'm trying to get straps out them projects, who I'm a call, nigga, that's news. Mm-hmm. Top goons in Philly, OBH, man, I'm involved with that crew.
Yeah.
I'm talking niggas who really inked in that bitch. Shit, you just a broad with tattoos. Nigga, you
talk about man. Niggas who really inked in that bitch. You just a broad with tattoos. Gotti was wildin', dog. And being the face of a woman league.
Right. You couldn't do it.
Yeah,
you couldn't
man.
Do it
I don't know, man. I don't know. And then the I do what I want, like, layout, you know, rhyme scheme was dope. And it was a moment where Easy, not Easy, but a cat from the Entourage would get into it with Rock. Here's why I felt like, damn, shit about to go left. Yeah, Rock up there arguing with somebody. I didn't know at the moment, at the time, I didn't know who Rock was arguing with. Did you know?
Yeah.
I didn't know who he was arguing with.
I was up front.
Yeah, they finna shut the battle down. Mind you, security, her security guards, these big ass, they, I don't know if they got blammers on them or what, but they in all black and they up there protecting Shorty. Mm-hmm. They like these. They making sure ain't nobody step. You know the red lines that be at the head. Yeah. If you ever been to an event, you know about the red lines. Mm-hmm. You gotta stay behind the red lines. They making sure shit is crick, man. Listen. They was on their job up there.
I do this shit for the have and the have nots.
Yep.
When Pat punched you, we was all wondering if you didn't have a have-nots. But you ain't.
You know, Pat punched you, we was all wondering if you didn't have a have-nots. Especially because the nigga didn't go live right away. Rock get calmed down and whatnot, and the show went on. Gotti got the walking again, bruh. He got the walking homie all the way the fuck down after that. Mm-hmm. The Eazy-E bar, you remember that?
Oh yeah, do I?
You was all at a bitch showing out so the streets could see. She hated to see her nigga with an attitude. She always prayed you would take it easy.
I like that. A nigga with an attitude. Take it easy.
I'm not about to.
Then he had the bar about putting out Doom. Come on, bruh. This nigga is wildin'.
Right. This fake fame started making your head bigger. She didn't want to go online and bash you, but you put her out the crib the moment you felt like you was past due. Nigga, that's true.
Past due.
Put her out the crib because you feel it was past
due. That entendre, bruh. Past due, you know, Hurricane New.
What?
Past, like, him overdue.
I told you he lost his
past due, you got to get put out. He was rhyme scheming like a motherfucker in this round. Like, and it was at this moment where they both felt like they were up 2-0. Right. Both of them felt like that. Easy was saying it's 2-0. Geechee would say it's 2-0. They going back and forth. The crowd going back and forth. They both is literally saying the battle was 2-0. Yeah, either Easy is saying it or Gotti is saying it.
Yeah.
And they both, but they both had the argument though. Like, right. They both was in there talking wild crazy to each other, bruh. The whole battle. And you even had some cats in there like, you know, 1-1.
Right.
Rightfully so. Like, the battle was like that, bro.
Right.
It was like that in this battle. The gloves were off. Go ahead, my fault.
I felt like in this second round, they both was on the same page.
Where you had to follow the storylines.
You got to follow the
storylines. Yeah, where you had to follow the storylines.
They're attacking each other's character. I just think Gotti did a better job at attacking his. You get what I'm saying?
Mm.
And it was facts behind it. It was believability. It was conviction.
It was, bro. And then him bringing out L. It was just like, it was a lot, bro. It was a lot.
It was a lot.
So Gotti got the second.
Shout out to Gotti. I mean, yeah, man. I know. Some, you know what? I don't give a fuck. I may come off bias, but I fuck with Easy. You know, I'm a fan of it. I'm gonna be real.
Let's call it what it is.
But listen, I'm gonna call it what
Gotti
it is.
Got
and
Gotti got the round.
Hold on. This is where I'm getting at. Gotti got the round.
Yeah.
Period.
Okay, that's it.
Period.
Just say that.
That's all we
right.
gotta say about
the
it.
The people gonna
God
think whatever
damn
they wanna think, but we was in their building and we watching the playback because the battle needs this. Like, this is not a battle you can watch the first time and be like, all right, well, such and such won. It can feel away, but, bro, they was talking, bro. It's not a battle funny where the punchlines is going to be super crazy on some Rum Nitty or New Jersey Twerks.
No.
They're literally rapping reality substance. Again, being very witty with the wordplay, entendres, metaphors. Mm-hmm. Very witty and clever with them boys putting together them rhymes up in there, bro. So
this is the real essence of
playback. So this is us doing our due diligence for real, because obviously in the building I felt like Geechee won the battle, but I'm like, did he win it like that though? Cause Easy, I knew for a fact was in there talking.
He was in there talking,
but was he talking? And on the playback, it looks crazier for real, man. Like, from just how they put together they shit to, like, me even feeling like, damn, this Gotti really won this battle like that, though. And Easy was fire. So I'm like, Gotti slight edge in the first, and he definitely got the second. So it's a 2-0 for me.
Yeah.
And then, again, one might want to argue it's 1-1. Let's just say that.
Right.
We get to the third round, and boy, Easy to block Captain Gold.
And nigga, I made y'all. When I talk to Rim about y'all bum ass niggas, I don't try to play y'all. I'm Will Smith and I Robot. I went against the machine to try to save y'all.
Y'all, yeah. I like that shit right there, yeah. Dog.
Yeah. Yeah. I like that.
Yeah, he got like it. But that. See, he gonna need a lot more of them in this third to close the show.
Right.
Because obviously Gotti's gonna have a lasting impression. That's what I was worried about.
It was a fire round. It was a very dope round because he talked about them boys being within the system.
Bro, I'm a weapon to them niggas. You made your league with a blessing from them niggas. I made my league because I was stepping to them niggas.
I ain't gonna lie, I like that talk right there.
I like that one. I ain't gonna hold it.
Hello, man came out.
trying to yoke by the back of the collar.
Yeah, nigga, talk.
The down. Yeah, talk. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that was
hard. How you felt about the round?
That was hard.
How you felt about it?
The third round, I felt Easy came out. I think this battle was a lot about momentum and getting the crowd in and out, and I felt like he had it coming in, but I felt he came in that third round. I felt like he was fighting, like he was climbing uphill for the first time in his career.
Since you spoke for the set, go for the tech, splash it, nigga. Know that wet Beyonce, everything for Bayer, go to the left, nigga. You.
I thought that was light cheese.
Light, but it was nice. But
I thought it was light cheese. Yeah. I even looked somebody in the crowd like, bro, that shit light.
Yeah.
Beyonce to the left.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I get it,
like
but
that.
it wasn't that. Where the crowd was in and out of pockets. They wasn't reacting to everything. They wasn't gassing everything.
He was fighting.
You know what I'm saying? So I think it might have fucked with him a little bit mentally because shit he might have thought was gonna land. Wasn't landing, and
it was fucking with him mentally because he was up there. He was looking super emotional.
Yeah.
Easy was doing a bunch of talking through the rounds, bruh.
And which he
don't ever do. Yeah, he did make a he made a big ass deal
at URL.
He did. You
he
right.
made a big deal about URL talking through his rounds and Calico. Yeah, and talking he, like, through the rounds.
Yeah, that's a fact.
So you know, he was just out of character in that third round, man.
He was talking like a mug, though.
That's not you.
But I mean, outside of that though, bar for bar, like he was detailing some ill shit, bro.
They definitely were. But they still bought it and had buyer's remorse. School online, I can show you the course. Broke the law, take it from Young Thug. There's no perk if you passed it in court, nigga. You was Marcus.
That's a crazy. It's no perk if you passed it in court.
Yeah.
No Thug, yeah, the shit that went viral, that nigga passed.
Yeah.
Crazy. Fire. Oh my. I see. So for me, bruh, here's where I felt like Buddy wanted this battle and he was starting to run away with it and he would get into the lesson in every bar.
We really had it hard. Picked up scabs, left nothing but scars. Before Teslas, we was charged up because my plug in the car. You know the
That is crazy, dog. Come on, man. That's lesson in every bar shit, dog. Be kicking. That should be moving spiritually, bruh.
Yeah. I'm gonna let you. Yeah, I know where you're going with this. I'm gonna let you go ahead.
It's simple, bro. Reality raps, reality substance. No matter how you cut and slice it, homie was in that bag. The plug. He said the plug. What do you say? The plug in the car.
Tesla.
Bar?
The plug was in my car.
Nasty.
The plug was. Yeah.
He got me on my What's boy name? That be. That's nasty. What's boy name? Yeah, Gwitty.
Nasty. We naming albums.
We named Buddy was in there wilding on Geechee with the lesson in every bar, bro. That was hitting. Like, this was a really good round from Easy.
Yeah.
Because he didn't let up off the gas pedal. I felt as though he wanted to win this battle, and he wanted to win it pretty clear. But what he didn't expect was Gotti had an ace up his sleeve. Oh, my Lord.
You ain't the only nigga to sell dope, we all did. I seen a fiend blowing a motherfucking pipe to the jaw stiffen. That work actually made him talk different. It's all
different. That is different, bruh.
That shit made actually talk different.
What? Come on, man.
This third round from Gotti reminded me of the earlier stages from Gotti, where he put together the classic third rounds every go around, though. Y'all know the fade Gotti? The fade Gotti? In the beginning of this shit, man, Gotti will walk these niggas down in the third, bruh. He did exactly that and some in this third, bruh.
Back of the project.
Yeah.
Rapping the brick.
Yeah.
Niggas never had me rhyme for him.
Yeah.
The first time I gave a nigga 3-4 rounds, God was the one who called time on him.
Oh! The first time I gave a nigga 3-4 rounds, God was the one who called time on him? Look at easy, man.
That nigga looking tight. He tight, nigga.
This was pure brutality. It is what it is.
Suck the fucking air out of that building.
These did, bro.
You ever seen?
He did, bro.
You ever seen Braveheart? Mel Gibson?
No, I never watched Braveheart.
So if you ever seen Mel Gibson, go back in your audience and know that part where they was saying they had Mel Gibson up against this thing, man, and they was about to castrate him.
Uh huh.
And if he would have said mercy, they would have just killed him right off the bat. But they was like trying to humiliate him, and that's what I felt like. I felt like, and it was just like, I felt like the crowd was just saying mercy, like let it just be over with. Even Remy was like go ahead and run it so we can get the fuck up out of here,
bro.
You felt that on the stage, and I'm not exaggerating it, man. I can hear it out of the crowd. They was just like, damn, bro, leave him alone.
Yeah. He was definitely meeting the substance of reality this round. They both was in that bag of just let me talk, y'all. Y'all hold it down. He need all this. Nobody say nothing. Just let me talk. And Gotti was talking in this round.
Man, let me find out. Gotti went viral, man. Let me find out.
No, but see, I like the fact that Gotti would even level up with the wordplay, though. Like, Gotti was in different attributes that we've never seen, though, like that from him. Not quite often.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Gotti made sure that he didn't leave any room for that debate to happen, bro. Especially in this third round. What are we thinking about Gotti, bro? Like,
that third round.
The NDA shit? The rhyme, the NDA rhyme scheme?
That third round.
Well, after I started reading the NDA, I started instantly laughing. Like, why would we need to sign an NDA if nothing didn't actually happen?
Right, nothing NDA, nothing didn't actually happen. Yeah. Wordplay.
Come on.
Gotti in his wordplay bag.
Come on, you gotta get tight. Look at Easy getting tight.
Gotti was all over the place in this joint, man. Real shit.
The NDA rhyme scheme and rap princess.
For what? Never duck.
What'd he say?
What the nigga say?
I know he said something. Need the duck at least.
Need the duck at least.
Yo, Gotti was in there putting on the punishment, dog.
You on the recording talking about I got caught lacking. Nigga, that's a sucker thought. You said you was on the ride with your nigga high saying, I'm sorry, E, I'm sorry, E. You said, shut up, it ain't your fucking fault. I'm from the era where if I fought, then my brother fought.
This guy,
that's a fact.
If a nigga around me,
that's a fact.
Go, bro. Gotti is literally exposing the tapes without exposing the tapes. He was literally exposing the audio. Remember the tapes that everybody talking about? We got these audio. He was literally exposing the tapes without even putting them out there. Like, but he was talking about the tapes very vividly. So when you listen to the rhymes, you like, you just playing this shit through. Like, damn, man, this nigga tripping. Easy was saying all of that. How? And why?
Oh. Because he got niggas thinking she letting this worker fuck the boss. He barely get battle rap pussy. I'm not even sure he can fuck the boss.
You know, little bitch that be in his face
is the boss.
With verb now?
Yeah.
Talk to this nigga, man. Gotti was in there wilding, bruh. You got the bag. I'm not telling nobody about the bag.
At all.
He said he was telling this motherfucker, that motherfucker, the one behind him. Yeah. He was telling her over there.
What'd he say?
He said he was telling everybody.
All the tea.
But it's crazy because Easy's argument in the second was like, yo, you gossiping.
Gossiping.
But so they both was doing one of the same. But Gotti was making it work in this room, and they literally turned on Easy. Like the first round, they was rocking with him.
Yeah.
But they was like, bro, this battle was over.
Right.
And we in the building. How the faces were in that building.
I was I was talking to the crowd.
I looked at a few faces. Yeah, the first face I seen, they was like this. Obviously, they were a fan of Easy. They like this.
Yeah.
The other face was like this.
That third round, he was stuck. They
was stuck. I seen my head. I seen the shorty. She was like these.
I seen shorty with that nigga. Body said something in the third. I looked at mama. I was like, that's a fact. I didn't even yell. You can hear me. Yeah, that's a fact. Mama looked at me like, that's right. That's a fact. Like
the crowd yelling 3-0 chants.
Yeah.
Bro, they were yelling 3-0 chants, bro. They yelling 3-0 in the building, bro. There it is. And he's not even done, bro.
He not even done.
They yelling 3-0 and he not even done.
Let's not skip past this because Gotti came in that. When I look at that third round, to me in my brain, it came in three sections. Gotti started off slowly cooking, and you didn't know what he was about to get to. Then he attacked Easy. And then he attacked Remy Ma.
Oh, the talk to Remy. Oh, my God. I mean,
it literally went in three sections. It started off. It was a slow
burner. Oh, my God.
It was a slow burner.
The talk to Remy, bro.
Why we ain't in New York? Because the last time there, your husband punched on him. So you actually brought it to where he more comfortable at. So if he did decide to show up, this weirdo can have the ups on him.
Oh my God. That's come nasty. On, come on, man. I know.
That is nasty.
I know. I know.
That's nasty work.
Gotti, man. He got us. Man, why he doing this?
I do what I want.
Come on, man.
That conversation with Remy.
Come on, man.
That's where the mercy came from. That's what they was saying. I had it.
Let me tell you. Listen.
If every interview, he show his admiration and tell the world how he think his woman the greatest. That nigga held you down in prison for 6 years.
Facts.
It was nice. He cried big.
Go.
What?
Just go, nigga. But here's why I said this battle is over. There's nothing anybody gonna be talking about but this motherfucking moment in time, bro. He literally had the ups on both of them all night long and nobody knew it.
When y'all go watch
Remy was disappointed. You can see it all in her face. Like,
go back and look at the faces.
Look at mama's face, yeah!
Hey, mother, go there!
Come on! Only Gotti can do it the way it was done tonight.
Right.
She was hard pressed, bro. She started sweating. I ain't gonna lie. I seen it. I seen the little drip. I'm standing right there. I seen it. Remy, I ain't gonna lie, mama. I see you sweating.
The hair was looking good.
Mama, shorty didn't like it at all. Homie was up there tripping.
He took you out to the best fools. When you ain't feeling good, he put you back in the best moves. So he be damned to see you get stepped to by a nigga he socked out and stood over like a sex
tomb. He'd be dead.
Constantly just bombing on this nigga,
man.
He
just
stood over like a
step.
Bombing
on
this nigga.
Look at
mama!
She paid a big bag to hear that.
And then the moment out around, though. The yes, sir.
Oh.
Yo, Pat, that's how you talk to your bitch.
Yes.
Yes, sir! Come no! On. Gotti was on demon time, bruh.
He lost his mind. And
oh, my nigga. Lord. It's over. It's over.
Over.
Oh. It's over. That nigga fucking fly. Over. I said, yep, it's over. It's over, Gotti, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, what? Look, 01 Kenny Smith. It's over, ladies and gentlemen. It's over. If you're a basketball fan, you know exactly the moment I'm talking about. The slam dunk contest with Vince Carter.
It's over.
Yes, sir. Gotti put his foot up in homie ass, and he kept it there, man, all night long. This battle was one of them.
You got knocked out by Papoose, and you lied about it.
You was a bitch.
You used to beat your bitch ass, and then you meet again, and you cry
about it. Nigga, you was a bitch.
You got knocked out.
Yes, sir. Yeah, nigga, you was a bitch.
He was so embarrassed about getting knocked out, he ain't gonna lie for a month.
That's a fact. You was a bitch, yeah.
You nigga really didn't go live, dog. I'm excited I got to see it live. I'm excited I'm able to just sit here with my dog and watch the playback because the battle needs this type of energy yeah. around it. And I'm very concerned for Rim because obviously that's a real situation, bro.
It is a real situation.
This is not no play shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We all watch these battles in awe. We all watch it for the excitement. We yeah. all watch it for the gossip. We yeah. all watch it for the entertainment. But at the end of the day, this is a real situation for her. This is a real situation for Pat.
Mm-hmm.
This is a real situation for Easy.
Mm-hmm.
And this is not a good look, bro. Mm-hmm. Every blog is going to pick this up. I'm telling you right now.
This ain't over.
And it's going to be a storm.
It's not even over.
Not just battle rap yeah. circuits. Right. We talking all the big leagues.
Yeah.
Rim one of them. Pat, really? They one of them.
Yeah.
We talk, you know, black entrepreneurship. We talk black power. We talk black love.
Black
we
love.
Talk black excellence. Yeah. They represent that. And Gotti exposed it for what it really is, right. man. What's going on up under in that castle, bro? Oh my God, this battle. Easy. Where do Easy go? Because obviously, Gotti got the third clear. Mm-hmm. Clear.
No debate.
We both are saying Gotti got the second. The first is debatable. Let's say Easy got the first. We can say that.
Right.
But I'm telling you right now, there is going to be a large portion of fans out there that's going to say Gotti got the first as well, which make this battle either a 2-1
or
convincingly
or a gentleman
or a gentleman's 30, bro. It is what it is. Gotti was in there round for round, pound for pound. He put that shit together the way it was supposed to be put together. You said it.
Yeah.
This battle is going to be based on the momentum
yep.
and how the rounds is going them to be constructed.
Yep.
How they were going to be constructed. And Gotti did a better job tonight. He was the better man. Easy is normally the better man on the night going against these. But Gotti showed his levels to this. I've been doing this, young right. dog, yeah. young pup. You following behind my footsteps now, but hold yeah. up, slow down. Let me teach you how to really do this.
Yeah.
And Gotti taught homie a huge lesson this night. Salute to Gotti. Salute to the whole, you know, the whole conglomerate. They allowed me to be around the festivities, you know, this weekend. I really appreciate it because they ain't gotta allow a motherfucker like myself to be around. And they allow me around, man. And it's always, you know, pure love. You know what I mean? And good energy whenever I'm around. It's never nothing else, for real. They popping bottles, they handing me a bottle. they blowing big bag. They trying to hand, I don't smoke, nigga. Stop blowing that shit in my face. But it's the energy I'm talking yeah. about. You know what I'm saying? I met my dog 500 through everybody around this bitch, and we, you know, we thug like that, man. But I felt this though that they was trying to set Gotti up, and I wanted to be there to support the boy. I didn't know how many people was gonna show up for him, but I popped out. Gotti was like, "Yo, you popping out of support? You gonna rock with us? It is what it is." So when y'all see me out there for the cats who did see me, that was the reason why I was out. And again, if you rocking with an entourage, It's a must that you go up there and you not, you know, do too much up there
people
for the motherfucker.
Understand
for
the battle. People don't understand, like the fans don't understand that there's stage etiquette. Especially if you standing behind some people, they're like, well, why are you not reacting? Because, you know, we've been here before and we can still do it. We gonna react, but it's not gonna be noticeable to you.
Yeah.
I might look over the shoulder and be like, oh, that shit.
And we was doing that.
I did it a couple of times. And a few of the fans
will tell you. I'm looking at some of the fans like, yeah, that was crazy.
That was crazy.
Or like, you just caught that?
I looked at Easy's his entourage a couple of times and was like, that was nice.
Nigga, buddy up there talking.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah.
But this was an incredible battle. I really hope, you know, all bullshit to aside, one, that Remy and Pap's situation get situated.
Right.
Because for me, I represent the art of black love. Me and my lady been together for quite some time now, and we done been through the mud.
Couple of storms.
We done been through the tornadoes. We done been through the earthquakes. But, you know, it took us to see the big picture. It took us to remain solid and stand 10 toes.
That's
and put them rain boots on and throw the rain jacket on and go out there with the hard hat nigga going crazy for one another and not allowing the outside noise really affect us and what we have going on in our castle. And it's hard. It's hard being a public figure. It's hard just being, shit, black, period. You know what I'm saying? In this world of sin. And it's very unfortunate. It's very unfortunate. I hope it gets better. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And Easy, don't cry in the car, man. You know what I'm saying? Listen. Easy got crazy tonight, though, but Gotti was just the better man.
This is a lesson learned, man. Yeah. Listen, if you got anything going on in your world that ain't right and you ain't got all your shit straightened out, don't fucking battle Geechee Gotti. Battle somebody else. That's not the type of nigga.
This is equivalent. This is far beyond what we expected. We knew Gotti can take it to a level with the thirds, i.e. Mike P. This one was different because he lined it up perfectly. The last impression, if you go crazy, 9 times, 10 times out of 10, the world is going to say you won the battle clear. We didn't even have to see a battle. All we had to see was this round, Gotti won it. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. He went from talking about homie, went to talking to the entourages, then to talking to Rim to close the show, bruh. And that shit was just way too effective. And the look on Rim's face after the battle was like, yo, we got to get out of here.
She wanted that third round to end.
Any last words for the people, man, before we get out of here?
Hey, listen, man. It's always an honor, man. It's been a minute.
No doubt.
And that was a dope moment. We got to go to the trenches and get the battle on stage and then come back in and recap it on a second look, man. And it's always an honor, man. I always appreciate you, man. And
no doubt.
Y'all got to stay tuned for this encore work you got coming up, man. I'm going to say what I got to say. I probably shouldn't have said it. I'm going to get fired now. I probably going to never got to do a battle again. I'm out of here.
You know what
I'm saying? Hey, listen.
Yo, it's the one and only Fanatic. I'm with my dog 500K. Y'all make sure y'all follow me on some of the social medias, the Twitters, the Instagrams. Talk to me on that. Please, I talk back. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Hit the like button. Share the video because that's the only way we're going to grow.
That's a fact.
My dog.
500K, man. Listen, we got to do one more thing, man. We got to get this motherfucker to 100K because he told me I get to interview him and give him his flowers when we get to 100K subscribers.
Please.
So we got to...
Y'all spam that like button. Make sure y'all share the video.
That's a fact.
Get other motherfuckers to the channel so they can subscribe as well.
Man.
But Battle Rap Fanatic, try to do one, I'm going to do two. If you try to do three, I'm going to do four, maybe even more. I go by PLLO. I think it's about that time, man. We got to go.